Hello students, myself Pooja Dokre. Students, today we are going to learn about electricity and circuits. So that, just open your textbook, lesson number 12, page number 116. Students, why we need electricity? So we use electricity for many purposes to make our task easier, isn't it? So in this lesson, we are going to learn about, see here, what is electricity, electric cell, electric bulb, electric circuits, electric switch, in that also uses of switch, homemade switch, switch in torch, and at last, what are the conductors and insulators. Okay, so these all points we are going to learn in this topic. So now first of all we'll see what is electricity, even what are the uses of electricity. Students, see here, electricity. Today we can't imagine our life without electricity, isn't it? Everything we use is operated with electricity. Now, electricity's extraordinary versatility as a means of providing energy means it can be put to an almost limitless set of applications, which include transport, heating, light, communications, and computation. Students, electrical power is the backbone of modern industrial society. The word electricity is from the new Latin electricius, amber like, coined in the year 1600 from the Greek, see this is a Greek letter, electron, meaning amber, because electrical effects were produced classically by rubbing amber. So electricity is the new Latin word, taken the word from the Latin language. Okay, now next point, electricity plays a very important role in our daily life. It is a form of energy that helps us in many ways. Most of the comforts of modern life would not be there if there is no electricity. Why, students? Because we need electricity at every stage, isn't it? For every work we need electricity. The electricity that we use in our houses, schools and factories is obtained through power stations. So how we get electricity? Through power stations. Okay, we get a small amount of electricity through batteries and cells. Okay, the electric power thus produced is used through circuits and controlled by switches. Okay, so the electrical power thus produced is used through circuits and controlled by switches. Okay, now next point, electricity used by everywhere, everyone and everywhere, isn't it? Everyone uses it and everywhere. Again, reduced efforts and time. Just because of the electricity reduces our efforts and even time also. How? In our kitchen, we use mixers. So that mixers also based on electricity, isn't it? So when we use the mixers, it reduces our efforts also and time also. Produced from power plants. So how we get electricity? From power plants. Okay, now all of you understood what is meant by electricity, even the uses of electricity. Okay, we'll see the uses of electricity in our daily life. Okay, electricity, see here. Car, cars, motor, drill. This motion, blender, motion or power are also dependent upon electricity. Here oven, iron, refrigerator, air condition, that heating or cooling purpose we use it, and they all depends on electricity. Okay, now here communication, see, computer, portable phones, radio, TV, these all are also dependent upon electricity. Even light, see, food light, flashlight, lamp, even the light lamp also, bulb also. So these all the things we use in our daily life, that all are dependent upon electricity. Okay, now uses and importance of electricity. Electricity has many uses in our day-to-day life. So just now I told you the examples also. Now people uses electricity for lighting, heating, cooling and refrigeration, and for operating appliances, computers, electronics machinery and public transportation system. Electricity use in the United States in 2019 was more than 30 times greater than electricity use in 1950. So students, this is very important. See here, what is the electricity use in United States in 2019 was more than 30 times greater than electricity use in 1950. So students, you can see the numbers that tells us about how electricity is important for today life, isn't it? So students, see here now in the textbook. See, we use electricity for many purposes to make our task easier. For example, we use electricity to operate pumps that lift water from wells or from ground level to the rooftop tank. What are other purposes for which you use electricity? List some of them in your notebook. So student, just make a list that what are other purposes which you use electricity. Okay, does your list include the use of electricity for lighting? Yes, of course, isn't it? Electricity makes it possible to light our homes, roads, offices, markets and factories even after sunset. So when there will be dark in the night, so we use light in our homes, roads, offices, markets and factories. This helps us to continue working at night also. A power station provides us with electricity. However, the supply of electricity may fail or it may not be available at some places. Okay, in such a situation, a torch is sometimes used for providing light. So whenever there will be no electricity, so that time what we use, students? A torch. Very good. A torch has a bulb that lights up when it is switched on. Where does a torch get electricity from? Can you tell me, students? So for the answer of this question, we'll see in detail what is electric cell. So in that we will get to know about where does the torch get electricity from. Okay, so see here students, electric cell. Electricity to the bulb in a torch is provided by the electric cell. So electricity to the bulb in a torch is provided by the electric cell. Electric cell are also used in alarm clocks. So where we use this electric cell, students? In alarm clocks, wristwatches, transistor radios, cameras and many other devices. Have you ever carefully looked at an electric cell? You might have noticed that It has a small metal cap on one side and metal disc on the other side. So students, you can see here metal cap on one side and metal disc on the other side. So this is an electrical cell and it has two sides. That means one side is having metal cap and here is a metal disc. Okay. Did you notice a positive sign and negative sign mark on the cell? So just you can see, you have a remote in your home, isn't it? So in that you have a cell. So you can see a positive and negative sign on the cell. Metal cap is a positive terminal of the electric cell. The metal disc is the negative terminal. So this metal cap is having positive terminal and this metal disc is having negative terminal. Okay. All electric cells have two terminals, a positive terminal and a negative terminal. So this situation you can see in all electric cells. That means every electric cell has a two terminals. One is a positive and another one is a negative. Okay. Now here an electric cell produces electricity from the chemical stored inside it. So now here, where does the torch get electricity from? So the answer of this question is here. An electric cell produces electricity from the chemical stores inside it. Okay. When the chemicals in the electric cell are used up, the electric cell stops producing electricity. The electric cell then has to be replaced with a new one. Okay, when the chemical stored inside the electric cell are used up, then electric cell stop working. Okay, so then you have to buy a new cell for the your work process. Now we'll see in the detail in the form of PPT what is electric cell. See, electric cell, it's a source of electricity. Okay, electricity is produced by the chemicals inside it, then used in camera, alarm clock and torch, etc. When it is one, we call it cell. When there is a one cell, we call it cell. But when it is two or more, we call it battery. Okay. Metal cap, that is a positive terminal, and metal disc is a negative terminal. See the pictures of a cell. Here is a metal cap, that means positive terminal. Here is a metal disc, this one is a negative terminal. And here, see in detail, positive terminal, negative terminal. Here the chemicals inside the cells are carbon electrode, that is a cathode, here separator and protective covering. This one is a covering of this. Again, ammonium chloride, that is electrolyte, zinc casing anode and manganese dioxide MnO3. Okay, so these are the chemicals in the electric cell which produce the electricity in the cell. See here, cells and batteries are here. So these cells we can use in a camera, remote, like this. Again, the batteries you used in your toys also. Okay, remote control car, again etc., like this. Okay, so these are the electric cells. Now structure of electric cell. The electric cell is a cylindrical device having a small metal cap on one side and a metal disc on the other side. Okay. Now the electric cell has two terminals, a positive terminal and negative terminal of the electric cell. Ordinary electric cells cannot be recharged. Okay. Those are the simple cells which cannot be recharged. But The electric cell, all batteries used in cars, cameras, mobiles can be recharged again and again for many years. Okay. So this is very important, students. Ordinary electric cells cannot be recharged. Okay. But the cells or batteries used in cars, mobiles, cameras can be recharged and can be used again for many years. Okay. Electric cells are used as a source of electricity in torches, wristwatches, alarm clocks, transistors, radios, cameras, mobile phones, toys and many other devices. So all of you understood what is meant by electric cells? Okay. Now we'll see our next point. Electricity can be very dangerous. Here, first point, I will explain now how electricity can be very dangerous. See, if electric wires and electric appliances are handled carelessly, then a person can get electric shock, which may cause severe burns and even death also. So, while handling electric wires or devices, you should be very careful, students. Okay. Improper handling of electricity can also cause fires. In case it may be catch fire also. A danger sign is usually displayed on electric poles also. Okay. On the electric poles, there is a sign of a danger sign. Okay. Now, electric substations, electric transformers and many other places to warn the people that they should not come in contact with them because electricity can be very dangerous. Okay. So don't go near to the electric poles, electric substations, electric transformers and many other places. Okay. Just they are having electric wires openly. So don't go there. We should never use electricity from power points or sockets in our homes or school for performing science experiments because it is very unsafe and dangerous to do so. We can use an electric cell to get electricity that is safe for performing experiments. An electric cell is known as a dry cell or cell. So all of you understood now how electricity can be dangerous. Now here on in the textbook, see here, a torch bulb has an outer case of glass that is fixed on a metallic base. See figure 12.2. Why is inside glass case? What is inside the glass case of the bulb? Can you tell me? See here. This is a bulb. All of you know. Okay. So why we use this? For the light. Okay. Now here this one is a filament and this one is a terminals. Okay. Now we will see detail in the torch bulb point. See activity 1. Take a torch and look inside its bulb. You can also take out the bulb with the help of your teacher. What do you notice? Do you find a thin wire fixed in the middle of the glass bulb? Yes, here we can find the thin wire fixed in the middle of the bulb. Now switch the torch on and observe which part of the bulb is glowing. The thin wire that gives off light is called the filament of the bulb. See here, this part will glow and this one is called the filament. Okay. The filament is fixed to two thicker wires which also provide support to it. This filament is fixed with two wires. See. This one is the filament and it is fixed with two wires. Okay. Now, One of these thick wire is connected to the metal case of the base of the bulb. The other thick wire is connected to the metal tip at the center of the bus. The base of the bulb and the metal tip of the base are two terminals of the bulb. These two terminals are fixed in such a way that they do not touch each other. The electric bulb used at home also have a similar design. Okay. Now, does both the electric cell and the bulb have two terminals each? Why do they have these two terminals? So, for this answer, we'll see PPT. Before that, see here caution. Never join two terminals of electric cell without connecting them through a switch and a device like a bulb. If you do so, the chemicals in the electric cell get used up very fast and the cells stop working. Okay. Now, see here PPT, torch bulb here, filament and terminals. The small electric bulb which produces light when a torch is switched on is called a torch bulb. The torch bulb consists of a small glass fixed on a metal case. Inside the glass bulb, there is a very thin wire fixed between two thick wires. Now, students, here in the textbook, they have asked us one question in page number 117. Working of torch bulb, that means why do bulb and cells have two terminals? So here is the answer. When the two terminals of a cell are connected to the two terminals of a torch bulb by using wires, the electric current passes through the filament of the bulb and it starts glowing. The torch bulb lights up when its metal tip and metal case are connected to a cell through wires. When electricity or electric current from the cell passes through the filament of the bulb, the filament gets heated too much. The filament becomes white hot and starts giving light. It is the heating effect produced by the electricity from the cell which makes a torch bulb works. So all of you understood how the working of a torch bulb. Now here see electric circuit. Electric circuit in which there is no gap in the connections between the terminals of the cell, wires and bulb, etc. is called a complete circuit or closed circuit. A bulb lights up when the circuit is complete. So before that, we'll see page number 117. Here, a bulb connected to an electric cell. See, let us try to make an electric bulb light up using an electric cell. How do we do that? Activity 2. See the answer here in activity 2. Take four lengths of electric wire with differently colored plastic coverings. Okay. Now, remove a little of the plastic covering from each length of a wire at the ends. So, remove it. This would expose the metal wires at the ends of each length. Fix the exposed part of the wires to the cell and the bulb as shown in the figure 12.3. See like this. Here are the wires, exposed wires, and fix with the help of the rubber band. Okay. Now, page number 118. Bulb connected to two wires. See, you can stick the wires to the bulb with the tape used by electricians. Use rubber bands or tape to fix the wires to the cell. Now, connect the wires fixed to the bulb with those attached to the cell in 6 different ways, as has been shown in figure 12.5 A to F. For each arrangement, find out whether the bulb glows or not. See, here are the 6 arrangement, different arrangement of a bulb and a cell. So here in the textbook, see here only A and F1 has only the bulbs are glowing. Okay, B, C, D, E are not glowing. Why? Because here A has completed its circuits, that means it's a closed circuit. Here B is a open circuit. Here in the C also open circuit. D here also open circuit. E also open circuit. Open circuit means that means it has connected to only one tip of a cell. Okay, but in the F1 it is a complete, that means closed circuit. So A and F bulbs are going. So that's why B, C, D, E are not going. Okay. Now students, here they have given the activity, write yes or no for each arrangement in your notebook. So you can write in the notebook also. Now carefully look at the arrangements in which the bulb glows. Compare these with those in which the bulb does not glow. Can you find a reason for the difference? Yes students, just now I told you about closed circuit and open circuit. It is me. So that one is the answer of this question. Now keep the tip of your pencil on the wire near one terminal of the electric cell for the arrangement in figure 12.5. Did the bulb glow for the arrangements in which you could not move the pencil from one terminal to other? See students, this you can try in your home also. So try it and write the answer properly. Now next point, electrical circuit. Students, this electrical circuit we'll see in our next period. So now in this lesson today, what we have studied students? Yes, we have studied meaning of electricity, uses of electricity. Even we have done the activities also. We have studied about electric cell, torch, how the torch also works, even the cell, terminals of the cell. So in this lesson we have studied about this much points. Now in the next lesson we will study about the electrical circuit, switch and electric conductors and insulators. Thank you students.